Hello all, myself Dr. Shanti Verma. In today's session, I am going to discuss e-commerce security for subject e-commerce. Let's first discuss the learning objectives of this session. At the end of this session, you are able to understand what is e-commerce security environment, what are the different dimensions of the e-commerce security, and what are the vulnerable points in an e-commerce transaction. Let's first discuss the e-commerce security environment. Basically, the overall size and the losses of the cybercrime is unclear, and the problem of that is a reporting issue. In India, there are numbers of cybercrime cases are occurred, but only 2% cases are reported. So it is a very big problem that cybercrimes are not reported easily. And according to a 2011 CSI survey, there are 46% of the respondents that firms detected a breach in the last year with a cyber crime, and it also affect the underground economic marketplace and the stolen information stored on underground economy to a server. So basically in the e-commerce security environment, the main problem is that the cases are not reported. So if cases are reported, we can maintain our security algorithms very strong, but if not reported, there is a problem between the security and the reporting issues. Now let's discuss what is a good e-commerce security. Basically, to achieve the highest degree of security, there are three key points. First, you have to use a new technology. As time passes, the cyber crimes or the types of the crimes are changes. So you have to upgrade it with a new technology so that these different types of the security threats or the attacks are detected by the new technologies. Next, you have to update your organizational policies and procedure according to the securities in the current environment. You have to change the security policies and procedure of your organization depending on the need and the time. Next, you have to follow the industry standards and the government laws that are built for the security of any e-commerce website. You have to follow the company's laws, the country laws that are formed for the e-commerce security. There are various other factors also, for example, time value of money. So it is very important factor is a time. If the time passes, it might be possible the security breach or the security problem occurs. So you have to upgrade it with a new technology so that this not happen. And it is your thought, what is important for you and what is the cost of security versus the potential loss. So if your data is not very important for you, you don't have to waste lots of money in the security. But if your data is very sensitive, you have to put some money for the security, that's so that you can balance between the security and the loss. Next is the security often breaks at a weakest link. So you have to keep in the mind that the every single weakest link in your network is watched by the attackers. So in your e-commerce website, there is no weak link that is available so that any attacker can threat your website. Now let's discuss the e-commerce security environment. There are the four factors that you have to mention in the e-commerce security environment. The first is the data, that is the raw data entered by the users or the company's data. Next is a technology solution. So you have to upgrade it with a new technology to maintain your data safe. Next, you have to implement or change your organizational policies and procedure to support the new technologies, and at last there are some laws and in the industry standards that helps you to change your organizational policies and the procedures. All these are interdependent with the each other. Now let's discuss the different dimensions of the e-commerce security. In this table you can see there are the two perspectives of the e-commerce security. First is a customer perspective and second is a merchant perspective. First, let's discuss what are the different dimensions. The first dimension is the integrity, second is a non-reputation, third is the authenticity, fourth is a confidentiality, fifth is a privacy, and last is a availability. Let's first discuss what is integrity. Integrity means sender pass the data, receiver receive the same data. There is a no changes or alteration in within the transmission of the data. So what is the customer perspective? Has information I transmitted or received been altered? Means if you maintain the information passed by the sender is same as received by the receiver, then you have to maintain the integrity of your system. What is the merchant perspective? Has data on the site been altered without authorization? And is data being received from customer is valid? So this is the merchant perspective, that the data from by the customer, that is the reviews and the ratings of the product, is not altered by the system. So if you maintain the integrity, your system is secure. Next is the non-reputation. Non-reputation means anyone can't deny of their authorization. For this customer perspective is can a party to take action with me later deny taking the actions. So anyone can't deny for taking the action if he or she is authorized for the same. This is the customer perspective. If merchant is claiming that this product is a returnable within the 10 days, so merchant can't deny to take this action. For the merchant's perspective, can a customer deny ordering a product? So if you by mistake you order any product from your account, you are responsible for this product ordering and you can't deny for this product order. Next is the authenticity. Authenticity is whom are you dealing with? Means are you authorized or authenticate to do the same thing? For that, for authentication, there is a technique, a password is used, and if password is matched, then the user have to perform the various tasks. So the customer perspective is how I can be assured that a person or an entity is who they claim to be. So if I say this product is a Lakme product, so is Lakme is identified that he or she is original. This is authenticity for customer perspective. For merchant perspective, what is the real identity of the customer? So the real identity of customer is shared with the merchant. There is no alteration or the modification in the customer identities. The next is the confidentiality. Confidentiality means can someone other than the intended recipient read my messages? So it is a very confidential message to a particular person. So customer perspective is if I send message to you, then only you can read my message and message is not read by the other person. For that, the encryption techniques are used. For merchant perspective, are the messages or the confidential data accessible to anyone other than those authorized to view them? So if the person is authorized to view the data, then he or she can only view that data. That is a confidentiality. Next is a privacy. In privacy, the customer perspective is can I control the use of information about myself transmitted to an e-commerce merchant? So if I don't want to share all my data to a merchant, so I can make a privacy techniques to maintain my data hide to the merchant. What is a merchant perspective? What use, if any, can be made of the personal data collected as a part of the e-commerce transaction? And is the personal information of the customer is being used in an unauthorized manner? So you, in the merchant perspective, you have to make sure that the personal information of the customer is not used in any unauthorized manner. The next dimension is availability. Availability means, can I get access of the site? And for merchant perspective, is the site is operational? So availability technique is, your services are available to everyone, so everyone can access your site. And for the merchant perspective, your site is always operational. These are the different dimensions of the e-commerce security. Let's discuss the tension between the security and the other values. The first thing is ease of use. You have to make sure that while you are adding the security measures, your site is not difficult to use or not slow. So you have to make sure that the more security measures are added, not a problem, but the more difficult a site is to use and slower than it becomes, it not happen with your site. The next is our public safety and the criminal use of the internet. So you know that the technology advancement also bear the different types of the cyber crimes. So the use of the technology by the criminals to plan crimes or the threaten nation state, that is not possible with your website. So you have to make sure that these not happen. Now let's discuss the different types of the security threats in the e-commerce environment. There are basically three key points of vulnerability in the e-commerce transaction or the e-commerce environment. The first is a client, the second is a server, and third is a communication pipelines, means the internet communication channels. So these are the three different points where you have to check that there is a no vulnerability or there is a no security threat. Now let's discuss a typical e-commerce transaction. Basically, in a typical e-commerce transactions, there is a internet service provider, there is a online consumer. So basically, the online consumer using internet, and with the use of the internet, he or she visit the online store, and this online store fetches the data from the database server. At that time, the merchant web servers and the merchant website is used, and with the help of the this online store, customer selects the product, and if he or she pay with the credit card, then the request passes to the customer credit card bank. And if he or she uses a COD, then there are some different methods are used. These credit card bank also deal with the merchant bank to transfer the money to the merchant account. And when the order is processed, the data released from the data warehouse, ship, and the customer receive their order. This is a typical workflow of the e-commerce transaction. Now let's discuss what are the different vulnerability or the key points where the security threats may be occur. So first, when online consumer uses internet, there are different types of Wi-Fi listening or wiretaps are available that may listen your data, and these are different types of the passive attacks. So you have to be aware about that. Now, when the customer visits your online store, there is a customer list hacking, means what are the different customers that use your online store. While the customer fetches data from the database server, it might be possible there is a different types of the SQL injection attacks that can be performed in a database server. While the customer pay the money using the credit card. There are different types of the DOS attack or the card theft occurs during the transmission. So this is a security breach. You have to make sure that this security breach not processed by the hacker. And while in the shipping, it might be possible your product is lost or your product is damaged. So this is also a security threat. So what are the different security threats in a e-commerce transaction? First is this Wi-Fi phishing. Second is this customer list hack. Third is a DOS SQL injection. Fourth is a DOS attack. And fifth is a shipping. So these are the different key points where you have to check that any attacker not process your security breach. So in the e-commerce security, you have to use some security techniques or algorithms to make sure that your security is not compromised. On the basis of e-commerce security topics that discuss in this lecture, I give you three questions. First is what are different dimensions of e-commerce security, and explain with customer and the merchant point of view. Second is explain the e-commerce security environment, and third is explain typical e-commerce transactions and the vulnerable points in it. For more learning, you can refer these references. Thank you.